In this lecture, we will make an ebook cover. So, what size should an ebook cover be? When we look on the Amazon Kindle website, we see that the average ebook cover has an aspect ratio of 1.5. An aspect ratio of 1.5 means that the height is 50% larger than the width. Also, a popular size for self-published printed books is 6 by 9 inches, which also has an aspect ratio of 1.5. So this matches. Now that we know the aspect ratio, how many pixels should our ebook cover be? Amazon recommends for an ebook cover a minimum height of 2500 pixels. Let's also have a look at the pixel dimensions of a 6 by 9 inches file at 300 dpi, which is needed for a printed book. I go to File, New. I click on Pixels and choose Inches. For width I fill in 6 and for height I fill in 9. I click on Advanced Options and set the dpi to 300. I click on OK. We can see we now get a file of 1800 by 2700 pixels. 2700 pixels is only slightly larger than Amazon's minimum requirement of 2500 pixels height. But our size meets the requirements for both an ebook cover and a 6x9 inch book cover for print. Let's save this document as a template for reusing. I go to File, Create Template. I will name it Book Cover 1800 by 2700. I click on OK. I close my file. If I now go to File, New, and at the top click on Template, I can see my ebook cover template. I click on it and click on OK. Right now, the file is shown at 33%. This means the actual size of the cover at 100% will be larger than my screen. Now let's open an image we will use for the cover. I have opened Skyline. The image comes from a website called unsplash.com. Unsplash offers free, high-quality images that come with a Creative Commons Zero license. This means you can use the images commercially. I drag the image over to my document. I move the image up so I see the water and the buildings. Now I will place some guides that will help me with placing my text. To do this, I press Ctrl A to get a selection around my document. Then I go to Select, Shrink. I type 250 pixels and press Enter. To place the guides, I go to Image, Guides, New Guides from Selection. I press Ctrl D to deselect. If I want to hide the guides, I go to View, Show Guides, or press Ctrl Semicolon. You can move guides with the Move tool while holding the Shift key pressed down. When I come close to a guide and the guide turns red, I can move the guide. I press Ctrl Z to undo. To remove a guide, simply drag the guide off the image. I press Ctrl Z again. To add guides by hand, go to View, Show Rulers. I can now drag guides out of the rulers. I will undo and hide the rulers again. The fonts I will use are League Gothic and Montserrat. I downloaded them from fontsquirrel.com. Fontsquirrel is a website for free and professional looking fonts that can be used commercially. The fonts have a SIL Open Font license. Click on Download OTF. OTF stands for Open Type Font. I open the downloaded folder. The font has 4 font weights. I select them all by clicking on the font on top, then press the Shift key and click on the font on the bottom. Then I press Enter. For each font, I have to click on the Install button. I close the window for that font and click on the Install button of the next font. To get good contrast for my title, I will use dark text because I have a light background. I will sample a color from the image. I select the color picker and drag inside my image. Let's try a dark blue. My title will be Summer in the City. I will make the text City large. I click on the text tool and drag a frame on the canvas. Because the guides are magnetic, I can drag the sides of the text frame against them and they will snap. In the tool options, I select the text under font and type LE. From the menu, I select at the top League Gothic. I press on Caps Lock to type capitals. I click inside the text frame and type City. In the tool options, behind Justify, I click on the centered icon. Then behind Size, I click in the text entry field. I press the arrow up key and hold it down. If the text frame at the bottom is too high, you can drag it down. By pressing Alt, I can drag and position the text frame. Let's experiment with the space between the letters. I drag the sides of the frame to the edge of the document, where they also will snap. Under Justify, I click in the Adjust Letter Spacing text entry field. With the arrow up key, I will increase the letter spacing. Now I duplicate the text layer. In the tool options, behind Size, I click in the text entry field. I press the down arrow key until about 190. I press the Alt key and drag the text frame up until it snaps against the upper guide. I select the text and type a summer. In the tool options, I select the text under font and type MO. From the menu, I select Montserrat Bold. I drag the bottom of the text frame up so the text frames don't overlap. Now I duplicate the text layer again. I press Alt and drag the text frame down. I select the text and type in the. In the tool options, I click in the text entry field and with the down arrow key, I set the size to about 100. I drag the bottom of the text field up. At the top, the text is ready. Next, I will create a line. I make a new layer by shift-clicking on the New Layer button. I press M to select the Rectangle Select tool. I drag the selection across the canvas. In the tool options, under Size, I will set the height of my selection to 5 pixels. I press 5 and press Enter. Let's pick a color for the line, an orange. On the left, I zoom in close. I select the color picker tool. To be able to take the color of a single pixel, I deselect sample average in the tool options. Now I can select the color of a single pixel. I open the color window and drag the red slider a bit more to orange. I press Ctrl 0 and press Alt Backspace to fill the selection. I press Ctrl D to deselect. I double click on the text of the line layer, type line and press Enter. I press V to select the Move tool. I drag the red line to the middle of the small text. I zoom in to 200% on the E. With my up and down arrow keys, I can nudge the line to the middle. I press Ctrl 0. I would like to see the line only here and here. To do this, I will hide the line with a mask and reveal the parts I want to see. I right-click on the layer and choose Add Layer Mask. I select black and press Enter. To reveal the line at both sides of the text, I press M to select the Rectangle Select tool. I drag at the left of the text in. The selection will snap to the guide. I press D to set the fore and background colors to the default. I press Ctrl Backspace to fill the selection with white. Now I drag the right edge of the selection to the right side. It will snap to the right ruler. Then I drag the left edge of the selection in. I press Ctrl Backspace again to fill the selection. I press Ctrl D to deselect. At the bottom, I will place the author's name. I duplicate the top text layer and drag it to the bottom. In the tool options, I click on the color thumbnail. I select white and click on OK. I select the text and type the author's name. Under Justify, I click in the Adjust Letter Spacing text entry field. With the arrow up key, I will increase the letter spacing a bit more. I click on the Move tool and press Ctrl semicolon to hide the guides. Our book cover is finished. So how will the ebook cover look like on Amazon's website? Before I make a smaller version of the book cover, I will first save my document. I go to File, Save As. I name my file City Book Cover. Now I go to Image, Duplicate. Now I can experiment with the image without affecting the original. I will start by turning my document into a single layer. To do this, I right-click in the Layers panel and choose at the bottom Flatten Image. All layers have now been merged into one layer. So, at what size are the book cover thumbnails shown on Amazon? At this moment, most thumbnails on Amazon are 160 pixels high. To rescale my image to the Amazon thumbnail size, I go to Image, Scale Image. I select the text behind Height, type 160, and click on Scale. I press Ctrl 1 to see the thumbnail at 100%. Let's place our thumbnail in the actual Kindle Store webpage. To do this, on my keyboard I have a print screen key. If you don't want to capture the entire screen, but only the active window, hold down the Alt key while pressing the print screen key. In GIMP, I go to File, Create from Clipboard. I press Ctrl 1 to get a 100% view. I drag the city thumbnail over to the screenshot file. I will drag my book cover over another cover to see the result. With my arrow keys, I can move the cover layer one pixel at a time for exact placing. While I'm working on the cover, I could also just zoom out to preview the cover as a thumbnail. When I zoom out to 6.25%, by control scrolling, the image will be 168 pixels high, just a few pixels larger. In the next lecture, we will create a more advanced book cover, where the focus will be on using blending modes.